Hello and welcome back to Kingdom Hearts Final Mix, where I'm not having fun, but I'm against what I am sincerely hoping is the final boss. If it's not the final boss, I'm gonna be steamed. But hey, this is what we got, this is what I'm doing, let's do it. Seems he takes decent amounts of damage. Unfortunately, since we're in a flight mode, we can't dodge anything. So if he decides to do damage, our options are parry or get hit. And then he does those lasers that we apparently just can't avoid because they're going to hit us unless we're on the move. Sometimes he has time between his attacks for us to do things, and other times he just does them. Can I, like, get in here? Smack that thing? Because I feel like getting in there and smacking that thing is what I'm going to have to do before this fight is over anyway. But maybe there'll come a phase, like, once I've knocked off a health bar or two where that opens up. Why? With the lasers? I hate the lasers. If I'm not moving, the lasers hit me guaranteed, and if they hit me guaranteed, then I take the hit, and I take damage. And if I take too much damage, I lose! This whole fight, everything Ansem does, it's like he's trying to make me lose the will to keep playing this game. And he is coming dang close to it. Oh, and that time I was on the move, but they still hit me. How did he hit me from that far away, or was it one of those little, like, bat things? Oh, hey, look, more lasers that you can't really even see coming the first time when you're up there smacking him, because the thing behind him blocks them. I'm sorry, but what about this is okay? Welcome to darkness. What part of this fight is acceptable? Like, what part of any of the fights with Ansem is acceptable? Like, oh, it looks like you've got an opening, but if you go in to try and take advantage of it, here's lasers. Oh, are you trying to get away from him? Well, there's these little bat dudes who are gonna come spike you. Oh, were you attacking me more than once? Well, I better attack back. And now we gotta get away, because lasers, we can only do like one combo. And by the way, those little bat guys, I can target them. I should get rid of them. But oh, if I get close, they're gonna stab me. And they take more than one hit to get rid of. And the lasers are murdering me. I don't like this. I don't like any bit of this. The only part I like is we don't got to do our busy work anymore. We just get to go against this guy a million freaking times until we inevitably win in this war of attrition. And sometimes we can manage to parry everything, and other times we just take hits. And here come lasers. Hey, that time I at least knew they were coming. Let's get some health. Hey, there's no bats right now. Oh, but now there's lasers. Oh, hey, look, it's bats. If only these bats would stay close enough for me to hit them and die quicker than they do. But they don't. Oh, look, lasers. Time to get hit by those if I stop moving. Better heal. Oh, but of course there's lasers to punish that. And by the time I get these bats dead, he'll have summoned more of them. The fact that the background is a featureless gray void really helps depth perception, by the way. Oh, and they take two full combos to kill. And that one didn't even drop Healy Spheres. And what? The lasers stay active that long? Maybe I should have kept Treasure Magnet. Jeez. Because I clearly can't get that sphere without it. I need health. Let's get away from him. Okay.
Welcome to darkness.
Oh boy, I love when laser thingies come from behind the thing that I can't put the camera somewhere else. Because the camera... Well, now I can see the laser coming, but... This is a time waster boss. That's what it is. It's a time waster boss. Because sometimes we get to attack, but most of the time we don't. Uh-oh, lasers. Better not attack him for a while. Oh boy, my favorite part of this game is when the bosses don't let you hit them. Okay, how... Oh, it must have been one of the bats that you can barely see because they are... Dark gray on a dark gray background. Like, killing the bats wastes way too much time. So you gotta just ignore them, which means you're gonna take damage. But, like, killing them, not only does it take time, it also, like, there's no guarantee he's not just gonna summon more. Because he is just going to summon more. It's a matter of when. And unlike every other enemy in the game, if I parry him during that little spinny move, it just prevents me from taking damage. It doesn't stop him from continuing his move. So there's nothing gained from it other than us not taking damage during that. It doesn't create an opening. It doesn't get us anything, really. How many lasers are there? Too many. Stop. Stop with the lasers. When am I allowed to heal? When am I allowed to heal? When am I allowed to heal? Stop! Just stop! What am I supposed to be doing right now other than just dodging infinite lasers? Do they stop? I've seen no evidence that they will. Are you kidding? Okay, are you done with your infinite lasers? Nope, here come more lasers. Please don't be infinite, because I am screwed if they are. Oh, nope, we've got more lasers, guys. Don't worry. Don't worry, there's more lasers. Oh, hey, guys, don't worry. We've got lasers. Oh, lasers. Oh, definitely got lasers. Oh, they weren't quite done. Nope, we still got more lasers, guys. Don't worry about it. Yep, we got lasers. Yep, there's lasers. Oh, I found the lasers. Oh, I got hit by the lasers. Why is infinite lasers mode allowed to exist? Oh, hey, look. Infinite lasers mode wasn't over yet. Oh, this will enlighten me? Do you mean more lasers? Are more lasers going to enlighten me? I feel so enlightened. Infinite lasers mode is my favorite mode. Hey, the heal went through after we took the damage. That's something. Oh, thanks, laser. I definitely needed you to have a persistent hitbox. That definitely makes this fun and exciting. Oh, yep. I love when it looks like I get to hit him, but then there are more lasers. That's the most fun part of the fight. The most fun part of the fight is when there are infinite lasers. Okay, so he says turn to darkness, and then there's one more laser. Okay, is... The shield isn't even down during infinite lasers mode. He just spams infinite lasers mode. What even is this? This isn't a fight. It would be a fight if I could hit him, but I can't hit him without incurring the wrath of infinite lasers. So he says turn to darkness, the lasers end for a moment. Oh, gee, thanks! More infinite lasers mode? Oh, I love this fight. This is exciting and fun and gameplay. Yep, I sure feel like I'm fighting a boss. And not like I'm just moving around aimlessly hoping lasers don't hit me. Which they do. Oh boy, howdy do they. So eventually he's gonna say, turn to darkness. And then the lasers will stop after one last one, of course. And then if I hit him anymore, he'll say, oh, still confused? Perhaps this will enlighten you. It's lasers. Forever. Did I just parry a laser? Either way, I'm not willing to give it more shots. Are the lasers faster now? The lasers seem faster now. Come on, just be done with lasers mode. Be done with every mode. Just be done. As a game, be done. Just stop. Stop making me play you. Let me be done. Yes, turn to darkness. So one more laser. Where's the one more laser? There it is. And already, before I even hit him, he's back in lasers mode. Got him. Are we done? Are we done? He doesn't look like a guy who's done. He looks like a guy who's still got another phase. Oh, would you look at that? He's a guy who still has another phase, unless this is a cutscene victory. Let it be a cutscene victory. I wouldn't mind. Oh, nope. We've got more. Oh, he's killing a bunch of little mini heartless who I'm sure can tear me apart if I let them, because, I mean, that's what we all want out of our video game, is for the final boss to have a phase of tiny little guys you've been fighting the entire time, but now for some reason they're more annoying and stronger than ever before, just because otherwise it wouldn't be appropriate for a final boss. Well, let me tell you, it's inappropriate for a final boss to even have these little bastards. There, are we done? Oh, no. Of course we're not done. Why would we be done? What even? Did we win? Or is that just the end of this phase? Of course it's just the end of that phase. Now we gotta go inside the barrier, don't we? But are we gonna have our friends? Because they were sucked in the barrier. Nope, we can't go inside no barrier. Why would you even think that? Ow. Oh, are we in infinite lasers mode, or is that just one laser mode? I'm cool with just one laser mode. I didn't mean to use Rivera, by the way. Okay, clearly I gotta get rid of these guys, because they're the ones that fire... Why is this allowed? Why is this allowed? Hey, we got two of them. You know, this, like many things in this game, wouldn't be a problem if it was more generous with its invulnerability frames after you take a hit. But here, if you get hit by a lot of things in quick succession, you're just dead. Your health goes away like nobody's business. It's not fun. Like, that's a mechanic for an MMO where a player can heal you. Like, a great example I have from around this time. Like, it released on GameCube the same year. I think it released on Dreamcast earlier. Phantasy Star Online Episodes 1 and 2. In that game, your invulnerability frames were determined by whether you were playing in single or multiplayer. If you were in single player, you couldn't be stunlocked by a group of enemies. Like, and what the hell am I even bouncing off of? But like, yeah, if you were hit by one enemy, you had a few frames where you couldn't be hit by another. And that made sense. But then, if you were playing online, now you can't get, you don't get those invulnerability frames, but you can have a friend heal you. And sure, this game, you can have an NPC heal you if they choose to and have the resources and are alive. But otherwise, you're just dead. Like, if there can be a player who is responsible for keeping people alive through things hitting them when they don't get any invulnerability frames, that's one thing. But when you're reliant on an NPC who is bad at the job, no one is going to like that. Also, these enemies remain annoying, especially in large numbers, because everything in this game is bad in large numbers. Also, why are we in such a dark place that we can't even see the enemies except their eyes and their outlines when they're doing their freaking magical effects? And what the heck did I just kill? Like, what even is that? But hey, I've rescued Goofy. Now he can be worthless with me. Because my allies are really bad when fighting bosses that have AoEs of any sort. Because they don't dodge anything. Ever. Oh, do I have to go in the mouth? Or do I have to kill the mouth? Oh, I have to kill the big freaking forehead of idiocy. And of course it's got multiple hit point bars. Why would it have only one? And also, of course it attacks exclusively with AoEs. Because why would we put there? Why would we have anything that's easy to dodge, or that your NPCs would ever try and avoid? No, we gotta have exclusively AoEs. If I stay far from the thing, will it just focus on me and let Goofy do his work? No, of course not. Why would it be easy? Why would it be anything that made sense? Why would there be any way to adapt to what's going on here? That's not how Kingdom Hearts works. Nah, Kingdom Hearts is about just taking damage and hoping you can cure yourself. Because dang it, it can't be arsed to do anything convenient or player friendly at any point in the entire game. I'd heal Goofy, but he would just die again. What's even the point of rescuing him first? Why couldn't I have had Donald? At least he is helpful when he's alive. Sometimes. Why is this allowed? Like, this boss. Every phase of it. Why is this allowed? Oh, there's that attack that has too large of an AoE for me to ever dodge. There. So what, do I go in your mouth now? Yep, I sure do. And then I get Donald back, I'm sure. Oh, let me in. Thank you. Oh, great. These guys, these are exactly the enemies I wanted to find here. You know, the ones that are responsible for more unfair deaths than any other standard enemies in the game. Yeah, those are the ones. I definitely missed fighting those guys. Especially in numbers. Okay, I'm keeping my health up. I'm hopefully getting his health down. Okay. Hold still for this. Thank you. Please tell me you're the last one. Of course you weren't. Why would you have been the last one? Nope, we've got this guy with just a few HP. All right, what stupid phase do we have next? I'm sure it'll be a bad one. I don't like this. This entire game, I don't like this. Well, hey, it lost its front bit. But it looks like it's got little faces down there that I'm sure are going to shoot things at me. Oh, or the barrier's down and I get to attack the heart, which I'm sure will have some utterly stupid AoE. And apparently the deck of the ship can cast spells at us. Let's get rid of these cannons so that they don't cause issues. So it looks like we get to just hit the heart. I'm sure it'll have an utterly stupid AoE, because why wouldn't it? Though I would love for this to just be a super easy final phase, made possible by the power of friendship. Just be dead forever. Be dead forever. Just let me win. I won't blame you if you do. I won't make fun of you. I'll just stop playing you forever, that's all. Just let me win. Oh no, did we knock Ansem free? Are we gonna get a repeat of the first damn phase? Oh, we sure are. Oh, that's gonna be so fun and exciting and different. Oh, look, he's even got the same max HP as he had before. Or at least the same number of hit point bars. And we get to start an infinite laser time? Oh, boy. So why can't I use Ragnarok here? What am I even supposed to do to dodge these? Am I just supposed to heal through that? Oh, I can hit the thing behind him now. Oh, only to stop it from attacking? Oh, hey, look, my friends are dead. Why were they even here?
Welcome the darkness into you.
Hey, everyone, be alive. I don't know why I picked them up. It's infinite laser time. And when it's infinite laser time, well, then they're going to get hit by lasers. Or actually, I guess I'm going to get hit by lasers while they do chip damage to the boss. Okay, for reals though, what am I supposed to do to dodge this? Am I just supposed to heal through that? Is that really what we're supposed to do? Uh-oh, better hit these before they can darkness our light. That's what they do, right? They darkness the light. As long as welcoming the darkness into my heart isn't infinite laser time, I'm cool with it. But no, it's infinite laser time. Okay, guys, just do your work. At least infinite laser time is better when you're around, because you actually get to do things to him. Whereas I sure don't. Okay, it's time for this nonsense again, so I'm going to be at full health at the start, because that's the only thing I can think of to survive this, is just spamming heals through it. Because we just take damage. Uh-oh, we gotta hit his darkness before our light gets darknessed. Okay, our light isn't gonna get darkness just yet.
Welcome the darkness into
I don't care. You're dead. I win. Please, don't have any more forms. Just don't. Just don't. I swear, if I have to... Okay, good. I didn't have to fight the ball of light. Just be dead. Let me...
It is futile. The Keyblade alone cannot seal the door to darkness. Kingdom Hearts! Fill me with the power of darkness.
Is Riku gonna come out and be like, no?
Supreme darkness!
You're wrong. I know now, without a doubt, Kingdom Hearts is light!
No, it isn't. That's giving this game too much credit, Sora.
Light. But why?
Come on.
But if it's light, why do we have to close it?
Stop staring and keep brushing!
Huh? It's an awful lot of heartless. Why does it...
I can't... Don't give up! Come on, Sora! Together we could do it!
Okay.
You're gonna get your fingers crushed, man. Yeah, why does it apply the motion blur to the freaking subtitles? Oh no, it's that guy! And also him again! How'd you get here? What?
Kyrie! Sora! Kyrie! Remember what you said before? I'm always with you too. I'll come back to you. I promise! I know you will!
Well, now that this is playing, I know that this is going to get copyright flagged, so it's going to have ads running on it from them, and, like, I don't monetize my videos, so it just kind of doesn't sit right with me when someone else runs ads on my videos. But it's gonna happen.
I don't think life is quite that simple. You are.
Hey, we reached the credits. Finally. I can say goodbye to this game. So yeah. I have been angrily saying so for a while so far, but yeah, the start of this game, it was okay. Towards the end, it was bad. Like, this game's mechanics do not work with what they were trying to get out of its boss fights or its trash gauntlets. The exploring the Disney worlds was novel, but utterly devoid of the charm that those Disney properties originally had. And ultimately, they added nothing to the story. So, like, what I'm really wondering at this point is, what did this game do that A, hadn't been done before, and B, wasn't done better by its contemporaries? Because if the answers are just having Disney characters and Final Fantasy characters, well, then I'll tell you that the Disney characters ultimately didn't matter to the plot, and neither did the Final Fantasy characters. Sora, Riku, Kairi, and Ansem are the only characters who made any difference in what went on, really. So, like, gameplay-wise, what did this game do that managed to get it so many sequels? Is there anything that this game did that was revolutionary from a gameplay perspective? Because, like, I can't think of any mechanics it has that were not better done by games in similar years. Like, I freely admit, when this game first came out, I wasn't super into action RPGs, so I didn't pick it up. Phantasy Star Online is the game that got me into action RPGs. I freaking love Phantasy Star Online, which came out either the same year or before this. Like, the Dreamcast version, I think, did come out earlier than this. And I feel like it's a much more solid action RPG. Like, the mechanics work. It doesn't ask you to do anything that it can't handle. The bosses don't do things that just aren't avoidable. Phantasy Star Online is a much better action RPG than this. There's other games of similar years that definitely have better stories. Like, I just don't get it. I don't get how people liked this game relative to its contemporaries. And I mean, sure, I'm positive part of it is just that I'm looking back on a game that is over 15 years old. But if you're going to say that that's the whole reason I'm saying that this game isn't great, then I'm going to tell you that some of my favorite games are older. Like, there are some games that are timeless. This ain't it. There are some games that aren't timeless, but that still have aged better than this. Like, there's just, there's so much that so many other games do better than what this game does. Like, Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles. Yeah, it came out after this originally, but I love that game to death. I will play it again and again and again. These are both action RPGs, but that one is way better. Because it turns out that when a game doesn't try and have you do things that its combat system can't handle, it's not so bad. It turns out that when action RPGs just have enemies on the field instead of having them spawn in when they feel like it, then there's not so much frustration with that. Turns out when games don't prevent you from interacting with things in the world when enemies spawn in, then that would make the enemy spawns forgivable. It's just, there's so much that could have been done better in this game. Like, I do see the hints of a decent game in there. But this needs so much polish. So much. And I just don't understand how it got as many sequels as it did when this was what people started with. I just don't get it. But again, hopefully the sequels will be better, will address all my complaints, and maybe I'll be converted yet. But for Kingdom Hearts 1, I honestly think you are better off just looking at a summary rather than playing this. This was not a fun time for me. I regret having played this. I don't say that about games a lot. But this is one of those cases where I sincerely wish that instead of playing it, I had read a summary. So please, Disney Interactive and Square Enix, please impress me with the next ones. And with that, we've apparently got another scene.
We've got to find Riku and King Mickey.
But, where do we start looking for that there door to the light?
Huh? Huh?
Pluto?
Hey, Pluto! Where have you been?
Huh?
Hey!
Gosh, that's the King's seal!
Hey, have you seen King Mickey?
Yep.
Guys, let's go!
Okay. Hooray, we're done. Apparently that makes me a novice player. And a final mix master. All right. That is it for this game. We are done with Kingdom Hearts Final Mix. I will never touch it again, I promise you. But we're not done with Kingdom Hearts, not by a long shot. Because we still have... oh, so many more games. Too many more games. We've still got all these, though it's my understanding that this and this aren't actually games, but are movies? If that's the case, they won't be going up on my channel, but I'll be watching them. But yeah, we've got all of these plus everything in the 2.8 Final Chapter Prologue compilation, and then also Kingdom Hearts 3. I'm gonna go through all of them. Unless I, like, if we get to Kingdom Hearts 2 and I'm still not having a good time, then I think I'll be checking out there. But yeah, Chain of Memories I remember really liking on Game Boy Advance. I hope I still enjoy it in this form, though I've heard this form is actually significantly worse. But hey, we'll find out. Either way, that's it for this game series. This series of videos is done. And I will see you in the next game, Chain of Memories. See you then, friends.